know, as a surgeon, you have to get out and promote yourself. Yeah. You got to brand yourself. You got to meet people. You got to build your practice. And I started from nothing. I feel like.
So would you choose ortho again? Because that residency's hard, dude. Like, you guys work a lot of hours.
I always tell pre-med students, man, you know, you have to look at the end goal. In the end, you know, it definitely pay off. It's just something you have to get through. It's hard, but what in life is not hard, though?
I don't got nothing to say. You know, sometimes I just lock myself in my room. I'm like, look, if I don't get this done, then I'm gonna be stressed out the whole time we're chilling. No, that's what I'll tell my family. I'm like, so let me get this done. Let me go through this short time period. That way we can all relax and enjoy our time.
I mean, you gotta hustle, you gotta grind, you gotta study, you gotta read. But in the end, it pays off, man.
Yeah, so you choose your specialty again?
Absolutely.
Nice. As physicians, you know this. You read all these books, you get in the OR one day, you see an anatomical deformity that you haven't seen before, and then you have to use your clinical experience and judgment to make a decision. And so behind that decision making is a lot of knowledge that you've accumulated.
Is that what MD stands for? Make decisions?
Yes, sir.
I thought it stands for make dollars.
Ooh. Maybe like 30, 40 years ago.
I'm joking. But yeah. My first day at clinic, man, I had like 2 patients in my office.
Dang.
To 4 months later, having almost 30 patients. It's crazy how much work you have to put into it and knock on doors, market yourself, give lectures. These are the things they don't talk about. Hopefully we can bring some of this on the show and just chat about it, man.
I'm in the big leagues, told them don't miss me. Ballin' like Houston, ayy, feeling like Whitney. Yeah, I need a bag, bruh, send it through quickly. I'm making his dog, like I'm in the big leagues, yeah.